We're back to talking about this new project that London and Dean has put together, this initiative that we have now named Motivate. And we've decided we're going to pilot this project at long-term care facilities. If you and I were involved in an accident and we were incapacitated, or our mom was incapacitated for a long period of time, we could find ourselves in a long-term care facility and we would need help to take care of our oral needs. What have you seen?
The same thing. And when you look at, you know, the transition from being healthy to being disabled, that you have a situation where we can use the basic preventative technique to prevent disease. We can brush. We have the dexterity to floss. And we have the ability to listen, and we have the ability to communicate with our physicians and our doctors.
Right.
Once we make that transition into a long-term care facility, we lose a lot of that control.
Absolutely.
So almost 70% of seniors in long-term care have some type of cognitive deficit. That's a lot.
Wow.
So their ability to function, their age to just living, their ability to brush their teeth, wash, they're really dependent on somebody else. So it's very important, if the individual cannot maintain their oral health care, it's really important to train the people that are assisting these patients to be able to know what causes the disease and how to prevent it.
What if they were on heavy medication also and they couldn't really help themselves? We need to train and educate the staff in this long-term care facility, the family members, their health providers. And that's what this project is so exciting, because it's the whole team approach that I think is so important. And I know with your research, if you have seen that.
It is, and that's what works. I mean, you have to make people aware and train them. And then you have to have a program that works. Because if something works, or there's a sense that people are doing something that's going to make their job easier and it's going to be cost effective, people will buy into the program.
Absolutely.
The London and Dean initiative will work, because ultimately it can give patients dignity, reduce the oral health, or what it means to most, it can reduce the bugs that cause disease.
Yes.
And what happens is patients can chew, they can function. The diseases such as systemic diseases such as pneumonia and other will decrease, and they have a healthier life. We have parents that are healthier that can smile if they're in long-term care. If we have family, friends, or patients, they'll be able to function much better.
Right.
And the other thing I think is important to realize is when patients are in long-term care facilities, most do not complain. So we have a population that really needs care. When they have severe pain or the inability to eat, they don't complain about it. So it's important as a community that we are aware for them, that we take a step up to make it work, and we can do that through this education program. It's also important to work together as a team. One of my favorite words is CONBIT, and it means, in Haitian, it's tilling the fields together. You cannot do this individually. You need every single person who's involved in healthcare to be motivated to work together for oral health. And ultimately, the end game is oral health is improved, diseases that affect the body will decrease.